Number three. How parents should live with the children and how should they treat them? And what is the status of daughters in Islam? And how they should be, parents should be dealing with the children, how should they be treating the children, raising them up, bringing them up. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala says, جَاءَتْنِي مِسْكِينَةٌ تَحْمِلُ إِبْنَتَيْنِ لَهَا. A poor woman came to me and she was carrying two daughters with her. فَأَطْعَمْتُهَا ثَلَاثَ تَمَرَاتٍ. I gave her three dates. فَأَعْطَتْ كُلَّ وَاحِدَةٍ مِّنْهُمَا تَمْرَةً. That woman, that poor lady, gave two daughters one date each. وَرَفَعَتْ إِلَى فِيهَا تَمْرَةً لِتَأْكُلَهَا. And one of the dates, she herself was hungry, and she raised that tamrah, that date, towards her mouth to eat. فَاسْتَطَعَمَتْهَا إِبْنَتَاهَا. Her daughters, when they saw this, they ate their own, and they looked at her, and they wanted, they demanded that that one date which she was trying to eat, that should be given to them. They asked for that also. What did she do? فَشَقَّتِ التَّمْرَةَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ تُرِيدُ أَن تَأْكُلَهَا بَيْنَهُمَا. This woman, when she saw that her daughters want that date too, she made two, broke it into two parts, to shiq, and he gave one to one daughter and the another to other daughter. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala says, فَأَعْجَبَنِي شَأْنُهَا. Seeing this, I was astonished. It moved me. فَأَعْجَبَنِي. فَذَكَرْتُ الَّذِي صَنَعَتُ لِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. I mentioned this incident and what this woman did with her children, with her two daughters. I mentioned this incident to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. فقال, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَوْجَبَ لَهَا بِهَا الْجَنَّةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Jannah obligatory for her. He made that she will definitely enter Jannah. أَوْ أَعْتَقَهَا بِهَا مِنَ النَّارِ. Or he said that Allah has freed this woman from Jahannam, from the fire of Jahannam. This is the Bukhari narration from Bukhari and Muslim, and the wordings are from Muslim. And in one of the narrations, in another tariq, one of the ways through which a hadith comes, he said, مَنِ بُتُولِيَ مِنَ الْبَنَاتِ بِشَيْءٍ فَأَحْسَنَ إِلَيْهِنَّ كُنَّ لَهُ سِتْرًا مِنَ النَّارِ. Anyone, whoever is put into a fitna or a bala, or in a test, if Allah puts a person into a test, in a fitna, in a trial, he is tried by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through these daughters. Daughters are a test for the parents. فَأَحْسَنَ إِلَيْهِنْ. But in this test, he does good to them. He treats them generously or well. كُنَّ لَهُ سِتْرًا مِنَ النَّارِ. These daughters will become a shield for him from the hellfire. So, in this hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that treating daughters well becomes a good deed so that a person is saved from the hellfire, or he or she will enter, this is general, this is not for the mothers only, man includes the father also. مَنِ بْتُلِيَ مِنَ الْبَنَاتِ بِشَيْءٍ. If a person is tested and tried by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through these daughters, and after receiving these daughters from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَأَحْسَنَ إِلَيْهِنْ, he treated them kindly. أَحْسَنَ إِحْسَانًا. So he does ihsan upon them. He provides them, he does talk to them kindly, and does not show to people that I have a burden in my family and Allah punished me through these daughters. So if mothers and fathers, they do not say like this, and treat their children and especially daughters well, kunna lahu sitra minan nar, these daughters will become a shield for them from the hellfire. So in Islam, daughters save the parents. Daughters are not a burden. They are the cause and means of saving oneself from the hellfire. So if parents treat the children well, these daughters well, they become sitr. Kunna lahu sitra minan nar. Sitr is something that keeps you apart from something. Sitr is something as a veil, a shield, something that comes between you and the hellfire. So this hadith is a very good hadith for parents, and it also shows that in Islam, daughters are not evil, and one should not be sad when there are daughters in the family. So in today's society, we see that the mothers-in-law, they are very unhappy with the daughters-in-law when they bear girls. They don't remember and they forget that they themselves were daughters once. So this is a fact they should remember, that in Islam, daughters are not evil and they are the means of entering Jannah, and they are the shield for a person from Jahannam.